Coming up this week on the show,
we get a recap on pageant.
We got to ask Kate about his magic.
I got to start the Black History segment this month.
It's Friday, February 2nd,
and the buzz starts right now.
Happy Friday, Fort Mill. I'm Kim.
And I'm Jackson. Here's Claire with a sports update.
Happy Friday, Fort Mill. I'm Claire Olson, and I am so excited to be your other sports anchor this year. Let's take a look at the Buzz Sports.
This life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. Eminem, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top.
Our boys wrestling team fought hard this weekend at the region championship and came home as 5A region champions. Congrats to our individual region champions: Luke Van Bynum, Jacob Nally, Lincoln Green, Tucker Gibson, Logan Shope, and Aiden Eubanks. Our varsity boys basketball played Rock Hill this week, and while they worked super hard, they were sadly beaten with a close score of 50-53. They play Spring Valley tonight at Spring Valley High School. Make sure to head out and support our Yellow Jackets. Our varsity girls basketball gave it their all on Tuesday and had a devastating loss to Rock Hill, 30-54. They have another away game tonight against Spring Valley. Wow, our winter sports are finishing up their season strong. Make sure to buy tickets and head out to support your Yellow Jackets. Now, let's take a look at Griffin and Cooper, highlighting one of our athletes of the week.
I mean, I remember watching him in middle school, and to be honest, he wasn't that good. But he's watching him over practice throughout this year. I can tell that he's improved a lot, and it really shows on the mat.
Lincoln's come a long way since last year. It's something that he works really hard at. I know when the season ends, it doesn't end for him. He continues to train all off season and works really hard at it. So he's come a long way this year.
The coaching's been like helping me out a lot. Like, they really push you to your limits. They like really help. They know what they're talking about. We probably have some of the best coaching in South Carolina.
Lincoln is already accomplishing big things and gaining the respect of coaches and varsity wrestlers. He's been wrestling for 3 years and recently won his first state championship.
It means a lot to me. It's like, I mean, it's obviously a big accomplishment.
Yeah, Lincoln definitely displays the ability to be a leader. Has to definitely grow into that role. He's young right now. But, you know, we have good leadership at the top of our program as far as our captains go right now. And I think he could definitely develop into a captain at some point.
If he continues working hard, he'll do great things.
Our winter athletes have been killing it.
So did the girls at the Miss Fort Mill pageant last weekend.
Here's a recap to capture the amazing night.
All the girls did amazing, and congrats to the winners.
It's February, which means it's Black History Month.
I did some research about the Rock Hill Nine.
Throughout the years, South Carolina has been the birthplace of many influential and important African Americans. An example of this is the Rock Hill Nine. The Rock Hill Nine, more commonly known as the Friendship Nine, were a group of African Americans who staged a sit-in at a segregated diner at Rock Hill in 1961. These nine men were arrested and sent to jail. These men were given bail but refused to draw attention to why they were arrested. They were forced to do hard labor for 30 days. They chose to do it to make a statement on how unfair the idea of segregation is. The Rock Hill Nine garnered worldwide support for refusing bail and exposing the corrupt system in the South. They jump-started the civil rights movement and paved the way for civil rights groups down the road.
Every week in the month of February, we want to highlight Black History Month.
We also want to highlight some classes here at Fort Mill.
Stanley went to ceramics to encourage students to add this to their schedule next semester.
Hi, my name is Ms. O'Shea. I'm one of the four visual art teachers at school here.
Ceramics is a great way to connect with your friends, plus get out your creative side.
I took ceramics because it seemed like a really interesting class, and I really liked to make pottery, and my friends were in it.
Since Dr. Passmore and I have gotten here 6 years ago, we have brought the program to from like five ceramics classes to 14 ceramics classes.
I needed an art class, and I did like drawing as well, but I thought it would be better to learn and like improve my knowledge in ceramics.
A way to kind of not do a lot of book work, but it's more about thinking and creative thinking and coming up with original ideas for yourself. And clay is a very calming kind of activity because you have to go really slow to get good at it.
Fort Mill has a bunch of different electives that are hands-on and bring out your creative side. Ceramics is a great example of this. Electives like this get you out of your comfort zone.
Thanks, Stanley. Fort Mill has a variety of fun electives, like ceramics.
And students from all over the world get to see what Fort Mill offers with the exchange program.
Ayla got the opportunity to talk to another exchange student.
I've gotten involved in the wrestling team, but also in UDP in a couple of matches. I wish I had an actual phone case because my phone just got destroyed in America. So, yeah. I would say prom. I think that is a thing that is like I'm looking really forward to. Yeah. Oh, the scariest thing is the host family meeting them the first time in person, because like you only talk to, over like phone or anything, and then like actually seeing them and talking to them is very scary. Do it. There's nothing that can like bring you down. Everybody is nice, and it's like the best experience you can do right now.
Thanks, Ayla. We love to learn cool facts about students.
Here's a cool fact about one of our students, Cade.
We learned why he does his magic.
I don't remember when my first magic trick was, but seeing my dad do a bunch of magic got me curious, and then I started learning magic. Actually, I do remember the thumb trick where you pull off your thumb. That drove me crazy on how it worked. So I looked up a YouTube video, and I figured out how to do it on my own, just trying to like figure out the positions. And knowing how to do that trick and then showing it off to my parents, that I loved that feeling, and then I just started learning more magic. Sometimes you don't get a good audience or you don't get a good reaction because they're not really into the trick, but when they are and you hear like, what, how'd that happen? That's probably like the greatest feeling because you stump them, you get them curious, and then that makes you feel great. Joe Berg and Brian, I don't remember his last name, but he's the director of Scam School. I watched a lot of them and that helped me get into what I do now. Also, guy on YouTube, MissMag822. What I recommend people getting good at? Yes, I recommend card tricks for your first time, just because there are some very simple ones, there's some automatic ones. If that is something you want to do, absolutely learn it.
Is this your card?
No! Wait a minute.
Wow, I wish I could learn magic.
That's all that we have for you this week.
Have a great Friday, Fort Mill.